So welcome everybody. We have been discussing about the implications of right understanding or understanding what is right. And yeah, can we move to the next thing? So, investigating into what is the implication of right understanding, we have seen that understanding this existential harmony, existential order, right, which is already there, this provides the foundation for identification of universal human values in all dimensions of life. So this is one important implication, that these universal human values are the natural outcome of understanding of this existential harmony, understanding of this coexistence, harmony and relationship. The second implication is that it also facilitates the recognition of the definiteness of ethical human conduct. And when we understand this definite ethical human conduct, then we can understand what we have been calling as ethics or professional ethics in the light of this, you know, clarity about the ethical conduct. So till now we have talked about these three things, right? If you remember, we have talked about the universal human values, which follows as an outcome of our understanding of this existential harmony. Then we have talked about this ethical human conduct, which is a natural outcome of living with these human values. And ultimately, we have defined how the ethics and professional ethics would look like in the light of this right understanding followed by human values and ethical human conduct. Now, if you look at other, you know, implication of this right understanding, in this lecture, we are trying to see that once we have the understanding of this existential harmony, it will enable us to visualize, you know, what holistic development would look like and how it will result into a human society and a humanistic tradition. So this human society, which we have been able to see in terms of undivided society and universal human order, is a natural outcome of understanding of this existential harmony, understanding of this existential order. And once we understand this human society and we work for this human society, a natural outcome of this is a humanistic tradition. Tradition of this human society, generation after generation. So in this lecture, we would try to understand how the understanding of the existential harmony, the existential order, understanding of this coexistence, harmony and relationship helps us to visualize how this human society can be realized. This humanistic tradition can be realized through the process of holistic development. So we'll see what holistic development would look like, number one, and number two, how it will result into this human society and humanistic tradition. So first thing that we can visualize is this comprehensive human goal that we have been talking about quite in detail. But we are just recollecting these things for our ready reference. So an important implication of this right understanding is the visualization of comprehensive human goal, which is conducive to human welfare, to well-being of all. In fact, if you look at the problem in the society today, one of the major problems is that we are looking at the human goal in a very short-sighted manner. What we were mentioning is, in the last lecture, that if we consider the wealth accumulation as the only goal of human being, then we are bound to get into trouble. And that is the main root cause of our problem today. So this comprehensive human goal, this identification of this comprehensive human goal, which includes all aspects of human existence, starting from individual to family to society to nature and existence, that is very crucial. So if we have the right understanding of this existential harmony and the human existence in the light of this existential harmony, then we can identify the human goal, both at the individual and collective level, in a comprehensive manner. So this is one important thing, right? And in the light of right understanding, it is possible to visualize a pattern for a holistic way of life to ensure the fulfillment of comprehensive human goal, a model for human living, which is people-friendly and eco-friendly and therefore sustainable. So unless we see this goal, the human goal, in its, you know, completeness, it will not be possible for us to visualize a way of ensuring the fulfillment of this comprehensive human goal. Only when we are able to understand the existential harmony and we are able to understand this comprehensive human goal in the light of that understanding of existential harmony, that it is possible for us to work out a holistic way of life which will ensure the fulfillment of this comprehensive human goal. And this holistic way of life will be people friendly and eco-friendly, and therefore it will be sustainable. So we'll look into those details further. Yes. So on the basis of understanding of this existential harmony, we get the notion of a human society, which is essentially the undivided society and universal human order that we have talked about. And the universal human order will involve two things. Number one, a holistic pattern in all the dimensions of human activity in the society, including education, health, production, justice, preservation, exchange, storage, etc. So in all human activities, all human participation in the society, right, we will be able to see a holistic pattern, not that they will be, you know, taken in a very fragmented manner and quite unrelated to each other. But there will be a holistic pattern which ultimately every time refers back to that existential harmony, to that coexistence, that harmony, that relationship. So all dimensions of human activity will be in that sense, you know, related, right, and in synergy. So this is one important thing about this human society, about this universal order. The second thing is that there will be a harmonious networking between the basic units and their clusters, successfully moving from family order to world family order as follows. So starting from the family order, we'll have village order, you know, and we'll go on building up, you know, to the national order and ultimately the world family order. And in each of these dimensions, we can visualize a human system, be it education, health, production, exchange, or justice, and conceptualize a harmoniously functioning overall system. So this is very interesting, that in the light of this understanding, we can now visualize a very systematic way of going about realizing our human goal. So we'll have different systems at every level, and we can go on building up different levels, you know, starting from family order to world family order. And each level, you know, we'll have systems which are in synergy, which are in a relationship of mutual, you know, supporting and fulfilling. And each of these level also will be in coordination, in, you know, mutually fulfilling way. So that is how the whole universal human order would look like. And if you look at what we have already discussed, you know, can we go to the next, Rajulji? Next is Rajulji, can we go? No. This is version 5. Okay, anyway. So we have discussed about this, you know, human society when we were discussing about the harmony in society in quite detail. So we are not going into those details, but you would have that in mind. Okay. So we can see that in that human society, we can identify the human goal. We can identify different dimensions of human society through which we can realize this human goal. And we have also identified the different, you know, kind of levels, starting from family order to world family order. So all that we have described quite in detail, but we are just recalling this here, that in the light of this understanding of existential harmony, it is possible for us to conceive and to, you know, kind of understand the human goal in a comprehensive manner, and also work out the way in which this human goal can be realized, starting from family to world family. So this is what we had discussed, if you remember. So this is possible to be realized through the understanding of existential harmony and order. Yes. Can we move to the next? Yes. And once we understand this, you know, the comprehensive human goal and the way to realize this human goal through a human society, we will also be able to work out how the human tradition would look like. So the primary step to move towards the holistic way of life is to develop the right understanding among the human beings. Commitment to live accordingly, and then to develop the requisite skills and knowledge systems to implement the right understanding in real life. This calls for a change in the education system towards humanistic education. And this right understanding provides us with the vision of such a humanistic education. And what we are saying is that once we have this humanistic education, then it will pave the way for a human society, and it will pave the way for a humanistic tradition. And if you look at this humanistic tradition, it can be visualized in terms of the following four aspects of a human society. So the four aspects of human society, which we have listed down here, will prepare the way for a humanistic tradition. So these four, can we go back, Rajiv? Yeah. So these four aspects of human society: number one is the humanistic education, number two is the human conduct, number three is the human constitution, and number four is the human order, the universal human order. So these are the four aspects of a human society, which put together gives rise to this human tradition, which can maintain this human society generation after generation. Right? It can maintain this human society generation after generation. And that is what we are calling as humanistic tradition. So not only that we can identify the human goal, we can also identify the human society in which this goal can be realized. And then we can identify this humanistic tradition in which this human goal can be realized generation after generation in a sustainable manner. Yes. So if you look at these details of, you know, this human education and human conduct and human constitution and human order, we have briefly defined it here. So human education has to do with education that ensures the development of the competence to live with definite human conduct. Right. And this definite human conduct is resulted on the basis of right understanding and right feeling in every child who is going through the process of education. So if you remember, in the very first lecture, we talked about holistic development and role of education. So our ultimate concern is this holistic development. And the process of that holistic development starts with human education. Human education, which ensures the right feeling, right understanding, and right feeling in every child, and thereby develops the competence to live with definite human conduct. Now, once we have this human education, we will have definite human conduct. So if we look at this human conduct, it is the conduct that ensures continuity of mutual happiness and mutual prosperity. So if you live with right understanding and right feeling, right, we are able to ensure this mutual happiness and mutual prosperity, right, in our relationship with other human beings and the rest of nature. So this right, you know, human education gives rise to human conduct. Now, when we have people with definite human conduct on the basis of right understanding and right feeling, then such people living together, right, will give rise to human constitution. So the nature of society of people living together in a relationship of mutual fulfillment, living with definite human conduct, that description, that, you know, nature is what is human constitution. So when people with right understanding and right feeling, people living with definite human conduct, right, when they live together, right, the description of how they will live together, what will be their way of going about, is what is human constitution. And with that human constitution, we will be able to realize the human order, universal human order that we have been talking about. And this universal human order is a society in which the human goal is realized through the different dimensions and different levels of human order, human society. So people living with this definite human conduct and living with this human constitution will be able to work out this human society, this human order. And in this human order, the human goal will be realized at all levels. So this society, this human order, is a society in which the human goal is realized. And we can see that a part of the activity of this human order, part of the activity of this human society will be ensuring the human education and sanskar. So if this human society is realized, it will take care of the human education in future, right, for the next generation. So this cycle will be completed. This cycle will be completed. So if you look at this human tradition, basically it includes all four these aspects, right, of human existence. It includes all these four aspects, starting with the humanistic education. We have human conduct. With human conduct, we are able to visualize the humanistic constitution. And with this humanistic constitution, we are able to ensure the human order, the human society. And in that human society, we are able to take care of the human education for the next generation. So this is the wheel of humanistic tradition. This is the wheel of human tradition. Right. And as we have seen, the basis for ensuring this is the right understanding, is the understanding of existential harmony, which is already there, which is already there. And you can also see that if we have to start this process, initiate this cycle of human tradition, then we have to start with human education. We have to start with this humanistic education, whereby we can ensure right understanding in every individual, every child who is going through it. We can ensure the understanding of this coexistence, this harmony, this relationship in every child who is going through that process of human education. And once we start this process, right, the whole cycle can be completed. And we will have this humanistic tradition generation after generation. So this human education is the entry point. And this is what we have been saying right from the first lecture, right, that lecture on holistic development and role of education. Yes. So I can briefly place this, you know, definitions about this reality that we have been talking about. It's not a complete description, but just, you know, recall for daily reference. So we have already defined these in module 1 to 4. However, we are recalling the essence of these for ready reference. Human education is education that ensures the development of the competence to live with definite human conduct through right understanding and right feeling. Human conduct is the conduct that ensures continuity of mutual happiness and prosperity through living with right understanding and right feeling. The human constitution is nature of the society of people living together with human conduct that is in a relationship of mutual fulfillment. Universal human order is the society in which human goal is realized through different dimensions of human systems. And humanistic tradition is continuity of human society generation after generation in a self-sustaining manner. So this is just a brief recall of what we have been discussing about this concepts, about these realities in our previous lectures. Now, the one important point that we need to observe, is that what we are talking about, the human society and human tradition, is something which is a natural process. It is not something which we are just constructing out of our own thought. So it is not just a construction. It is not just an artifact, right? It is something which is a natural process. This we have to understand. This we have to understand. And it is very important to understand this. So what we are saying is that this human society and human tradition is something which is a natural outcome of the existential harmony, of the existential order, already existing and unfolding itself through a natural process. And this process is to be completed through human being. So this is very important to understand. So when we're discussing about the existence as a whole, when we are discussing about the harmony in existence, we saw that existence is in the form of coexistence, which is in the form of units submerged in space. And this coexistence is unfolding itself in the form of material units, in the form of units of consciousness. It is unfolding itself in the form of four orders in nature: the physical order, the bio order, the animal order, and the human order. And we said this unfolding of coexistence up to this point of these four orders is already completed. And we can also see that the first three orders are already in harmony, right? They have definite conduct. We also said that the existence of human order is already there. But this process of unfolding of this coexistence, this existential harmony, is to be completed through the human being. Is to be completed through the human being. And to complete this process, human being has to understand this coexistence and live in this coexistence. So when he understands this coexistence and he lives in this coexistence, then this human society is a natural outcome of it. This human society is a natural outcome of this. So we were saying that, you know, when you look at the human being, it starts with realization of coexistence and it completes in the form of authentication of universal human order, of human society, which includes both this undivided society and universal human order. So this natural process of unfolding is already taking place. It has taken place up to the existence of human order. And it has to be completed through the human order, through the human being, by way of realizing this existential harmony, by way of realizing this coexistence. Right? So this we have seen, that through the human being, this natural unfolding of coexistence, this process of natural unfolding of coexistence is completed, right, to the point of universal human order. And when we understand this, we can see that to meaningfully participate in this natural process, human being has to understand this existential harmony and to live in accordance with it. Right. So you can see that this human society and the human tradition is not just a human construct. It is not just a thought experiment of human being. Of course, when we are talking about it, it is something which is articulated and expressed by human being in different ways. But it is a reality. It is a natural process. It is a natural process that is taking place, right, in existence, in the form of natural unfolding of this existential harmony, natural unfolding of this coexistence. So this is important, that what we are saying about this human society and what we are talking about this human tradition is not something which is just a human construct. It is something which is a reality, something which is, you know, a natural process of unfolding of this existential harmony, unfolding of this coexistence. But of course, it has to be completed with the meaningful participation of human being. And that meaningful participation of human being is to understand this existential harmony, this coexistence, and live in this coexistence. So this is a very important point to note, that human society and human tradition is a natural process. Of course, when human being try to understand this, articulate this, and express this, they may express it in different ways. They may do this understanding, the articulation, the expression in different ways. But it is a natural reality. It is a natural process of unfolding of this existential harmony. So this is something which we have discussed quite in detail, if you remember, and Rajulji has placed it in this slide, that this existence, which is in the form of coexistence, which is in the form of unit submerged in space, this coexistence is unfolding itself. Right? And it has already unfolded itself up to the existence of human order. And through human order, through human being, this unfolding of coexistence has to be completed. And it is completed by way of realization of coexistence and authentication of this coexistence through undivided society and universal human order, through this human society. So this is a natural process. We have to understand this process and we have to be with this process. And we have to be the meaningful, you know, participant in the completion of this process. Completion of this process of unfolding of coexistence, unfolding of existential harmony, existential order. Yes. Of course, there'll be many discussions on this, which I think we'll take up. So key takeaways basically is this two things. First, on the top two things, right? The one below we have already discussed. So this humanistic education leads to human conduct, human constitution, universal human order, and in turn, universal human order ensures humanistic education for the next generation. So this is one important thing. The other important takeaway is that if we have to start this wheel of humanistic tradition rolling, it has to be started with humanistic education. So the entry point in setting the wheel of this humanistic tradition rolling is the humanistic education. So this is the essence of what we have discussed in this lecture. Of course, most of the concepts that we have discussed have already been discussed in quite detail. So rather than discussing them in detail, what we have tried to do is to recall them and place them here for ready reference. But you can look back to all those, you know, detailed descriptions which have been given in the previous lectures and recollect them here. So with that, if there are any questions, we will take them up. So a lot of that recalling has to be done and, you know, putting them into place, but we have put them just for ready reference, you know, some of these concepts for you to connect to the fact that one of the important implications of right understanding would be to understand what is the holistic development and how this holistic development can be realized through right understanding, number one. And number two, this holistic development would ultimately mean that we are able to ensure a human society, right, from family order to world family order. And we are able to set up this humanistic tradition, which can ensure this human society generation after generation in a sustainable manner. Yes. So with that, I think I can open it to the questions. So any further detail if required, I can respond to it.
Is Rakesh Pandey ji? Or Yogita ji from Rajkot? Okay, so one thing that comes up, Ganesh, is that what are the kind of capabilities that one needs to work on?
Your voice is not very clear to me.
Is it better now?
Yeah.
Yeah. One thing that comes up is what are the kind of capabilities that we need to develop for even grasping what is being said.
See, if you look at all that we are discussing, you know, particularly in this module 5, we are saying that the fundamental thing is the right understanding. And right understanding means understanding of the harmony, which is already existing in this existence. And then we have tried to unfold it in detail, you know, saying that understanding the harmony at different levels of human existence, starting from human being as an individual to family, to society, to nature and existence. So the most important competence that has to be built in is this right understanding, that is understanding of the harmony at different levels of human existence or different levels of existence as a whole. So this is first competence that we have to build up. Second competence that we have to build up is this, you know, right feeling and right thought on the basis of right understanding. So that is the second competence we have to build up. The third competence that we have to build up is this, you know, competence to ensure the right behavior with human beings, right work with rest of nature, and ultimately participation in the larger order, at least in the family order to begin with, right? At least, you know, participation in the community level, what we are calling as village order. And ultimately, we have to develop the competence to participate in the world family order. So that is the kind of competence that is required. And then in the light of this, you know, we said that if this competence has to be developed, then first we have to know about ourselves. Right? We have to be aware of ourselves. We have to know about our own sanskar, our own assumptions, or our understanding, right? So basically, we have to investigate into ourselves as to what kind of imagination is going on in us, what kind of feelings and thoughts are there in us, whether they are in line with this coexistence, harmony, and relationship which is naturally acceptable to us, or in, not in line with it. If it is in line with it, it is fine. If it is not in line with it, then we have to ensure that, you know, we have to set it in order. So we have to ensure that every feeling, every thought that we have is in line with coexistence, harmony, relationship. So that has to be done. And then when we are interacting, and this we are doing through exercise one, if you remember. And then if we have to interact with the world outside now, you know, we have to do that as well. So in every interaction with the other human being, whether I am able to understand this relationship, accept this relationship, those natural feelings in me, and any fulfillment of these feelings in the human being or not. Similarly, be aware and have ensure that every time I am interacting with the rest of nature, ensuring the mutual enrichment, that is, I am able to ensure the prosperity for human being and preservation of rest of nature. So like that, you know, I have to be aware and I have to ensure that I have this understanding of existence, harmony, and relationship. I have the feeling and thought of this coexistence, relationship. And I'm able to fulfill this in my behavior, in my work, in my participation in the world. And this we are doing through exercise one and exercise two. We have to build up our competence through this exercise one and exercise two that we're talking about. By being aware of oneself, by way of having this clarity, this understanding about the coexistence, by way of having this feeling and thought of coexistence, and then developing the competence to live with this coexistence, harmony, and relationship in our with human being, in our work with rest of nature, and in our participation in the larger, starting from family order to world family order. So that is the kind of preparation that is required. And if you look at all that we are trying to do is in the light of this, right? And for this purpose. So whether we are talking about the foundation course of on universal human values, we are basically talking about preparing ourselves for this. Whether we are talking about this understanding human being comprehensively, whether we are talking about working towards a, you know, human order, we are talking about this whole process, how we can go ahead